Hi girls, this is Sheila. Welcome to another tutorial. You all must have seen the Kim Kardashian look for the Met Gala, and it was a huge hit in the makeup sense. So I really loved the look as well. I had a poll, everyone voted that they want to see a wearable version of that look. That makeup wasn't actually over the moon, but it was so nicely done by, I think Mario did it, and it's amazing. So this is how Kim Kardashian looked. And this is her with this makeup look. So today it's going to be a really long tutorial because it requires a lot of detailing on the face. So I will be doing it in two versions. There will be about 10 minute videos. One of them will be for the whole face and the rest of it will be for the eyes. So if you want me to start, let me tell you, I have only put some moisturizer and that's it on my face. I have no resemblance to Kim Kardashian, all of you know. My color tone is not same. I have this big round face, but it's not about what you have, it's about what you want to create or what you have in mind that you want to create. So to start with, I will be starting with Terry. This is a new serum that I got. It's a brightening serum by Terry. And it's pretty nice and it gives a very nice and fine glow to the face. So, and very lightweight, it smells like a rose. It's amazing. So this is like a very light serum. The next will be, I will be using by Laura Mercier. These are, you can see, like glow primer, radiance primer, glow radiance primer. So I will be applying a bit of it on the places where we need the glow. I don't want to apply it on the whole face, but when I blend, it will definitely move around a little bit. Doesn't matter. We will mattify everything. So it is all about creating a very nice, beautiful canvas for your makeup. Kim Kardashian's makeup artist is Mario. I regularly follow him and I wish to attend one of his master classes that he does here and there. I missed a chance in London, but next time, there is always a next time. So this is now, the skin is prepped and nice. When you want to wear something that's for a long time and I would prefer only Huda foundation. This is in a pot because what I actually did, I had a light color and a dark color and I had to mix them two together to get the right exact color for my skin tone. So this is why these two are in a pot. And I mix them together to create my color. These you have to work fast with Huda foundation. The coverage is really high, but you cannot leave it like this. You must see that it has covered the skin really, really well. I won't do much under the eyes at the moment and won't conceal either. There is a reason for not doing that because once we have these shadows on, it will definitely be a fallout. So I'm reapplying only in the area where I need more coverage. We all have those areas where we need more coverage. I will do a thin layer of concealer. Under the eye, I am going in with the Huda foundation and then I will go in with the concealer. So now, the biggest thing will be about contouring and about bronzing the face. I will go in with this. So this is by Dior. It is a contour stick by Dior. And for if you see Kim, she has like all of her faces almost in a very nice contoured way, and this goes here, this goes here. I might do some things that I don't do regularly, so just keep an eye about that. So we are trying to create a shadow. So let me blend for blending. There are many options. Sorry about that. So I will use something that will cause a nice chiseling effect. So I'm going in with this Real Techniques brush. I will definitely go in with another one, but I want only the product to be dispersed nicely and still maintaining the chisel off my face. So this is where I blend a bit of my nose contour. Once this is done, I will take a fluffy brush like this and start going into the. You have to work quickly with cream products. Once they set, it's very difficult to move them. I know the contour is not well blended at the moment, but it will all be gone. It takes a lot of patience and practice to do this. So we have created shadows where we needed the recede. So all these shadows have been blended now. Now the next step will be going in with NARS Paloma, my favorite contour. And I will be using the contour and I will be using the bronzing as well, because the skin for Kim Kardashian is really bronzed. She uses pretty dark bronzers and she has a tan. So let's try to match something where I won't be like that at all, but we can definitely try as much as we can. So I'm just blending in, going over the cream contour with my powder contour Paloma by NARS, the best one out there. So once I'm trying to create this blending look, I need to go in on the nose. I will take this brush, this is by Stila. I know this looks pretty harsh here. I'm going to clean it up. I'm going to make them more cleaner towards the edges. So the nose still looks a bit more. I'll just take off the excess product. This is done, and the next step will be using of our nice bronzer for the face. So let me get this bronzer for you. This bronzer will be by makeup. This is it. So go in with this, tap off the excess. I know the bronzers are supposed to go with bigger brushes. I will go in with the bigger as well. At this moment, I'm only trying to create the depth.